What's up, guys? I had to take a few weeks off to take care of some personal stuff, one of which was my boy Devin's wedding. Had an absolute blast, met some awesome people, and actually had some time to unwind and relax. It was a great change of pace for once. But in doing so, I neglected some product reviews I was all set up to do. Needless to say, if you're a manufacturer and watching this thinking, man, fuck this guy, that's why. Sue me, I'm sorry. I'm back and hopefully on track now. Anyway, today I wanted to go a little more in depth in regards to nicotine salts and freebase. Specifically, 5 reasons salt nicotine is better than freebase nicotine. If you have yet to check out my breakdown of what nicotine salts are and how safe they are, be sure to check the description below for the link to that video. Today we're going to discuss the comparisons between the two in detail for those interested. As I've said before, salt nicotine is not new by any means, but it has recently taken a large upswing in popularity. There's also a lot of misunderstandings about it. Some hate it, some love it, but one thing's for sure, it's not going anywhere. And the primary reason for that is many people are finding success in quitting smoking using salt nicotine versus its normal or freebase alternative. I should say right off the bat that this video is not an attack on freebase, okay? And I'll likely make a counter video as to why freebase is better than salt nicotine. This is simply a discussion video that is aimed at creating conversation, breaking down some of the myths and misunderstandings behind salt nicotine. Let me hear your thoughts in the comments below. Okay, so this should be a relatively quick video, and my hope is that it can be kept under 5 minutes, but you know how these things can go, so let's go ahead and do it to it. Let's begin by going over the basics of what both of these products are. Nicotine salts contain the exact same nicotine that's found in its natural salt state in the tobacco leaf, although acids that make it absorbable to our body's bloodstreams are often added. Freebase nicotine is the result of a method used by tobacco companies since the 1960s, so nothing new. By manipulating the pH levels in the nicotine, it provides more potency without increasing the dose. This is also possible in your e-liquid mixes, but we'll save that for a future video. Right now, however, we're going to get into the advantages of using salt nicotine over freebase nicotine. First, let's get the obvious out of the way. It is cheaper. A lot of people don't understand what that means, but let me break it down. When we say it's cheaper, we mean it's cheaper to use. While the price tag may appear a bit higher when buying it, it's going to cost the user a lot less in the long run because you actually vape less often. The product itself ends up lasting you much longer than its sub-ohm counterpart, where it's not rare to go through 10 to upwards of sometimes 30 milliliters of juice per day. Of course, on the flip side of that coin, freebase isn't going to last you as long, meaning you'll be buying or mixing more often. I think this is where the confusion comes into play, so hopefully I broke that down well enough that it's easy to understand. Next, let's talk about something Salt Nic lovers are emphatic about, and that's the smoother throat hit, especially with nicotine salicylate. That crystalline product could take up an entire video on its own, so I'll spare you the breakdown for now. Perhaps we'll talk about that in the future. A huge turnoff for many would-be vapers is that conventional liquids can be a bit harsh, usually attributed to the companies using cheaper, lower than par quality nicotine. Except in many cases where overflavoring is to blame, especially in higher levels. Actual cigarette companies use eugenol or menthol to mask and cover up the harshness. E-liquid companies don't, however, so the smoother hit from Salt Nic liquid can make a huge difference. A simple test that you could conduct yourself, if you have the materials, is to mix up a 6 milligram bottle of Salt Nic and sub-ohm it beside a 3 milligram bottle of freebase. You'll be shocked at just how similar they really are. By general rule though, you should not sub-ohm Nic salts over 6 milligrams, though I've heard some people taking it above 12 milligram in sub-ohm tanks, while I don't recommend it, what works for you is what works for you. I'm 100% behind getting people to quit smoking at whatever level is satisfying to them. And I should say this is not just a widely spread opinion I'm going off of, but nicotine salts have less of an impact on the flavor of your liquid. Freebase nicotine affects the liquid's overall flavor potency, while salt nicotine leads to a fuller, richer, and more flavorful experience. This, of course, comes in handy since pod recipes require a higher percentage of flavoring already. So whether you're mixing your own or buying as a consumer, if you're somebody who puts away a bottle and forgets about it, or if you're someone who simply has a lot of liquids on hand, salt nicotine is much more stable than Freebase and is going to give you a much longer shelf life. Now, I'm sure you guys have heard about benzoic acid. It's typically used in food preservation applications, and it's also often used in nicotine salts and further aids in preserving your liquids. This is another reason why a lot of liquid manufacturers include saline in their Freebase products. Now let's cover the final reason that salt nicotine is better than Freebase nicotine. You can use less powerful devices. I understand a lot of people love their high-powered devices. Okay, I do too. Believe it or not, I do. But the fact is, a lot of people just want a cigarette-like experience without having to blow massive clouds and drawing a lot of attention in public, while also only having to carry around a compact and discreet device. This is the primary reason I use MTL devices in public, to both be respectful to those around me, but also to efficiently administer nicotine to my bloodstream. It's nice to have a small device that easily slips into the pocket or elsewhere, i.e. a bag or your glove compartment, middle console, wherever. There's more reasons as to why smaller devices can come in handy, but I'll leave that to you guys for the comment section below. Let me know what you guys think, what your experience is with mixing Nic salt, and any advice that you would offer to new guys. Until next time, cloud salute.